Oh, later.
What a beautiful day. Beautiful day.
I got a man they brought him in. I haven't got him out yet today. But have they started coming for him?
What?
I can't.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Where'd you get that sunburn, Marlon? I mean, some of us have been working.
You out in California.
Some of us have been working.
You got it out in California.
Congratulations,
George. Did you say
I stole, hey, George. I stole your line shamelessly. Oh, this is something.
We don't know the scenario. We're going to go through it. Let's go.
Jimmy, we're going to go out on the steps. I'll be at the podium first. George will be at my right. Barbara, you'll be at my left. Dan, you will be to the left of Barbara. And you to the left of Dan. And Nancy, you'll be there, George. Okay. Nancy, there.
We got
it. Yes.
Just hang out here. We'll leave those to you. Sam Donaldson back, or is he still on the furlough?
To have you here, and if anyone wants to know how Nancy and I feel about this moment, just read our smiles. Actually, though, I have some figures here that I thought you and the rest of the country might be interested in. According to my calculations, it's only appearance and character and grit that you've shown in this difficult year, and I think two of your worthy opponents would agree what a challenge to human endurance a presidential campaign is bringing it out. You will be true to your promises and faithful to the people's wishes. To George Bush and Dan Quayle, I feel our achievements are
based on modern presidential politics of a president who worked so hard to help someone else achieve this office. And I'll always.
What do you think of Jim Baker as Secretary of State?
Let the women go!
I think you can find every job that he has in the administration.
Hold on. Brady, you were the member. What about Nicholas Brady, who's the president?
Mr. Bush, do you plan to go to Europe before your inauguration to shore up the NATO alliance in the wake of ongoing arms control negotiations?
President, do you feel like a has-been, Mr. Reagan?
Mr. President, what can you do to pave the way for a Bush-Gorbachev summit, since Mr. Bush seems so anxious to meet with the Secretary?
Which really means that it will be white, losing white hair, and it's important in the majority, but I mean, on substance, he was never with us.
Now the two of you are going to be alone in your
chair in a long time.
No.
The horse guy, he's got a house right off on the seashore. And so Brian and I are going to just spend about 4 days there. But he's getting done. About to work. But again, thank you for, God Almighty, what you did.
I'm pleased to do it. I'm there doing every day what I was only doing some days.
I think all this stuff, I mean, the most negative campaign, all this thing that they picked up and used is the whole source of his last minute survey. I just am convinced that'll be put behind us.
George, there was an article in the paper the other day, and by a scholar, an op-ed piece about all this crap about a dirty campaign and so forth. And he went all the way back to Thomas Jefferson. Good Lord, you can't believe some of the things.